podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1417, Dynamic Pictures. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Last week on Monday, episode 1411, I showed you this cool trick where we had dynamic pictures that were appearing in response to the slicers and also the smart art. Yesterday I talked about how to do the smart art, which is interesting. Five people figured out how to do that. But the picture, most people used VBA. I want to show you this cool trick for having the pictures change in response to basically selecting a number. So let's just start off here. We'll get rid of this picture. Let's say we start with one really tall cell. I make the cell very tall. I want to insert a picture in that cell. So if you're in Excel 2010, go to Insert, Screenshot, Screen Clipping. Now what this is going to do, it's going to go back to the last active application. So before I do that, I want to go find the web page that has the picture that I want. Make sure that it's in view. And then we will go back to Excel, Screenshot, Screen Clipping, wait for the screen to kind of gray out, and then just use the mouse to draw the rectangle. All right, there we go. So we've inserted that in our cell. I'll make it a little bit smaller so that way it fits. All right, so that's the first step. Then, from there, we go down several cells and insert the other pictures, one in each cell. Make the cells tall enough to fit that. Okay, now we're going to use the camera tool. It used to be called the camera tool. It's not called the camera tool anymore. We're going to copy this cell, Control-C, and then come over to a new spot, and we will paste and use the linked picture. Linked pictures. Let me scroll over there. Okay, so now whatever happens to be in that first cell will appear in this cell. And if I would do anything to the first cell, like for example change the fill color, you see that it changes over here in the picture. So this is a live view. It's a cool little trick, right? But here's the thing that makes it really, really powerful is I'm going to build a formula, an offset formula. If we take a look at this formula here, it says that we're going to start from J51 and we're going to go down some number of cells. So whatever number happens to be here in K51, in this case, down two cells and over zero columns to point to the cell that I want. Now I'm not allowed to use this formula unless it's assigned to a name. And when we assign it to a name, it actually has to use the full sheet name. So sheet 3 exclamation point, and then here sheet 3 exclamation point, and we'll add dollar signs. I'll press the F4 key to make sure that there are dollar signs everywhere. So there's my formula. I want to assign that to a named range, and we do insert. Look at that. Back in Excel 2003, it was under insert. It's under formulas, and then define a name, and we'll call it cool trick pick, and it refers to that area. Click OK. All right, so now we're coming along. Now I'm going to go back here to my results of the camera tool. We're going to select that. Right now this is hard-coded to say it's equal to J52, which is that cell, but I'm going to say that it is now equal to cool trick pick, and when I press enter, that's going to change to the state of Florida. Bingo. And then all we have to do is have some mechanism, or maybe a formula or something, that changes the number here, and it will grab the next picture from the range. Now again, the trick here is to make sure that each of these cells is exactly, each of these pictures takes exactly one cell tall. So make the cells taller, the rows taller in order to handle that, maybe just have it off to the side or something like that. And a very cool way, without any VBA at all, to instantly update the picture that's shown in response to this value or formula. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast on Mr. Excel.